Hello, my name is Anna Belcarcel. I am a fossil preparator at the American Museum of Natural History. We are standing right outside the fossil preparation lab, and we're about to take a sneak peek behind the scenes. Right through these doors, we walk into the main space of the lab. To the right, you'll see the workstations for the individual preparators, a Protoceratops skull and an Oviraptor nest, an Apatosaurus femur, and various other specimens at different stages of preparation. Here we have a mold of an Oviraptor nest and its cast. Those specimens are going back to the country they came from, so we're making replicas at the moment. Here we've arrived at my bay, my workstation. The specimens that I work on are mostly South American mammals, a large group of mammals called Nodoungulata. These are animals that lived in South America during the Eocene, Oligocene, and some of them in the Miocene as well. Preparators here in the lab normally use microscope in order to see the finer details of preparation. But we also use very traditional and rudimentary tools like these pin vices you see here, and these needles that we have to sharpen every few minutes, really, to get a fine point and get the fine detail. Brushes, of course, and tweezers and other dental tools as well. What we are looking at right now is a fossil specimen from the Chilean Andes. It's a mammal skull, and you can see pretty easily the shape of it. We've got the orbit right here, and over here we've got the rostrum here in the front and the back of the skull here. And we don't really know how much more of the skull is in this block because the matrix is very dense, and even under X-ray CT we really can't tell how much of it is here. But we are hoping that the teeth are going into the skull in this direction, and that we've got at least part of a tooth row. So we're going to take a look at the specimen under this magnifying lens so you can see exactly what we do as preparators here in the lab directly from our perspective. So I'm going to be using a pneumatic tool, this air scribe right here, which is a tool that's got air running through it and a steel tip here in the front. It's very loud, and it's going to be drilling away the rock in order to expose whatever specimen is in here. So I'm going to be putting the tool right next to the rock and try to chip it away very slowly. As you can imagine, I can do a lot of damage to the specimen if I'm not careful, so I'm going to be working pretty far away from the specimen itself and just trying to remove as much of this bulk rock that's surrounding it. These specimens are collected in very high altitudes and remote areas of the Chilean Andes by our AM&H expeditions, and they're about anywhere between 24 and 35 million years old. So the last thing I want to do is to work too quickly and damage any part of the specimen and lose that data. Once I get closer to the specimen, I'll move on to a much finer tool, like this one here. It's another air scribe. Again, it's powered. It's got air running through it, and another type of needle. It's a little bit finer and more stable than the one we saw before. And because it's more delicate, it's going to be removing a lot less matrix than the tool I used previously. However, I can get a lot closer to the specimen without risking damage. So as you can see, just a little bit of that rock is coming off very, very slowly. And something like this would take me a couple of months to prepare. So if you were to come back in 3 months or so, we would have a lot more of this skull exposed. Hopefully, we will have found some teeth down here. And the reason why teeth are so important, especially in mammals, is because they give us a better idea of exactly what taxon this specimen is. You can identify it a lot easier. You can see there the rock coming right off. And then as I get closer to the specimen, I would be moving to what we call needles on pin vices. You can see this is a very, very small needle with a flat pointy end on this pin vise here. And a needle like this I would sharpen a couple of times a day just to make sure I had the sharpest edge. And a needle I can use right against the bone here. As you can see, we're removing the rock just a couple of grains at a time. You can see some of that dust coming off as I scrape it. And normally I would be working under a microscope just to get much closer to the specimen to see exactly what I'm doing. But the idea is to use a needle so that we can work very slowly and not damage the specimen as we're exposing it. Again, this is very slow work, so it requires some patience. But the beauty of it is that once we're done, we could potentially have something, a taxon that we've never seen before. And that's that. And this specimen here is something I've been working on for the last 6 weeks. You can see we've got the top tooth row and the bottom. It's unusual for us to find a skull that is this complete. Again, this is also from the Chilean Andes, Oligocene in age. So it's relatively young compared to some of the other specimens here in the lab. You can see the skull roof, the orbit here, and the zygomatic arch on the lower jaw. So at this point, the specimen requires just a couple of weeks of more work. And the idea is to get right in between these occluded tooth rows and with this very sharp needle, just grain by grain, remove the last bit of rock to expose those crowns that are going to give us a much better idea of what this specimen actually is. And there you have it. How's that?